Okay, friends. Hi. This is kind of a part two, and please forgive me. I've had tremendous issues with filming today. So, just a good learning opportunity. But anyway, I was talking about bioidentical hormones. I for years used bioidentical hormones. It was more rustic back then. I did massive research on how to support my body as naturally as possible. I am literally down to natural thyroid only. There was a season where prescription meds were given to me for everything because I became so ill with all my autoimmune. PCOS does kick you into that autoimmune category. At least that's what I found out during the Big C. And our pandemic, and I don't really have a comment on that other than I do know it has been a major factor in my life. I've also been to doctors, friends who are nurses that said, "Oh, go see this doctor," and then they put you on glucophage, I think what it was. Wow, that was a huge mistake. And that was just me. This, I'm not saying if it works for you, you have to do what you need to do. But for me, I felt like a lab rat. I really did. It was so early on in the knowledge of PCOS, at least in our area, in the cities that I lived in. And San Antonio is a pretty big city with a really nice medical center. So I just feel like maybe there was just a lot lost in that kind of journey, part of my journey. But sorry, I guess my little pumpkin candle's been going the whole time, and whoo, it's getting a little strong for me. I don't know what to do because I spent like 2 hours in between these videos trying to get things worked out. I also have a new camera. I've been trying to get that worked out. So, anyways, but I do think there's a lot to be said for bioidentical hormones. I believe, my type of thyroid medication, and I don't have a thyroid, is one that I was immediately put on the synthetic, and I immediately got off of it. And within a few weeks, it just they're just things like that that you just have to do your own research. And again, I'm not a doctor, I'm not a nurse, I'm not a medical professional. This is just my journey, and that's all I'm sharing. Now, if you guys have anything to add on hair removal, I think it is worth sharing. I know there's a lot of information out there. There's a lot of things that you can do to prepare your skin before, prepare your skin after, or to repair your skin after, because it doesn't matter what you use, whether it's a razor or an epilator or any of these things, waxing, it's going to cause a little bit of trauma to your face, it just, especially people with sensitive skin. And I was sharing that my daughter has also been diagnosed, my youngest, with acute atopic dermatitis, and she had a breakout on her arms, and it looks more like psoriasis. But at this point, it looks like I had them run a culture this week. Last week, they would not. And I just could not get her in. I literally called all over Austin and they couldn't get her in until literally March. March. It's September, guys. This is crazy. What is going on? So, okay, there's my little rant, but I'll get off that soapbox. But so anytime you have acute atopic dermatitis, you have to do a sample spot. You have to do a little bitty tiny spot, give it a try and then move forward. At least for me, I have to. And I highly recommend that being your practice in everything from, lotion to makeup to anything. And I had talked to my daughter, about be very careful because sometimes, because they had her on an antibiotic twice a day, double, and then two different creams. And when I looked them all up, they were all things I was not familiar with. They covered like viral, fungus, bacterial. It was like, what in the world is going on? Steroid, what in the world is going on here? So basically, this sweet young doctor, or not even a doctor, a PA, which we were not told it was a PA when I made the appointment, but I was glad to get her in the door. And I requested that this Tuesday that a doctor be pulled in and take a look at it. They kind of gave her some song and dance. And I told her later, you do know that wasn't real, right? And she was just like, well, that's what they said. I said, no, honey, that's not, She did not want to be basically countermanded. She did not want to be, I'm sure it makes her feel bad if they bring in a doctor. And I said, but the main thing is, every time she walked in that door, it was $150+. Besides, now we're paying for a culture. Well, she should have run week one. So as you look at these things, you have to be sure what your skin can take, what you might have a reaction to, like I did with bleaching. And, well, bleaching I did okay. The waxing, I think it had to do something within the wax, because one time it was okay, one time it wasn't. And it may have just been the way it was applied. I did better at home than I did in a salon type situation. But all I can say, and cleanliness is a big deal. And, you know, and I had my my first laser hair removal done in the dermatologist's office. Yeah, I mean, that's way back when. So, and then later I had it done in a salon, in a laser hair removal salon. That's all they did. But, so I think you have to determine how you want to go about this. Now, I saw a commercial where a gal proudly wore her mustache, and good for her. I just wasn't raised in that era. And, you know, my husband has been very sweet through the years, because this is something that has horribly embarrassed me. And his mother even did something that horribly, and she knew what she was doing, bless her heart. She was embarrassing me. And I just cannot say any more than you have to be comfortable with yourself. You have to do your own research. And remember, 40 years ago, we didn't have internet. We had to rely upon doctors because the books were too old. So I think, or at least I didn't have access to that kind of resource. It really wasn't available like it is today, and you had to trust doctors. And so now, as time goes on, I think because the information is more available, because people are able to understand these things better, and because of the ability to read online and do your own research, and everybody thinks everything on the internet is 100% true. Well, we hope so, but I think doctors and their experienced doctors are worth their weight in gold. And, but I don't think you just take it at face value either. You know, that's what I'm trying to teach my youngest this last week. And a lot of it, she doesn't want to make a scene. She doesn't like, you know, any kind of ruffle. But sometimes, guys, with PCOS, you got to ask the questions. And if your doctor is so easily offended that when you question or ask a question, not even question them, but ask a question and they explain it and you still don't understand it, then you just have to say, I'm so sorry. I still don't understand what you're telling me. Either can you break it down further, or can you refer me to something I can read or study or any of that? Do you have any literature? And anymore, they don't have literature. They just give you a website to go read, which is fine. But again, don't read one source. Read multiple sources. So it's your body. It's your decision. I don't know how this relates to keto, except for that it's just been a big topic lately in the keto community. And I just think PCOS, this is just one area of PCOS that people either are fine talking about or they're not at all. And if you're my age, you may be not. So I've stepped out way out of my comfort zone. And, but I'm here to say, try different devices, try different things, see what you like. And again, you can use the little twinkle flat razor. You can use an electric razor. You can use a regular like shaving razor, but be really careful, you can cut yourself. On the twinkles, it's pretty hard to cut yourself, but you can, so take it easy. And then you have the electric, and then you can use of course the epilator. But I would get one for the face, definitely. I think that one's too rough. I think that's gonna be great for legs and underarm. Find one that's better than this. I think that bronze one is probably gonna be the best, and I will come back with that. And it may just be in the form of a short. You can bleach, you can wax, you can laser treatment, laser hair removal treatment. And I know people that are even doing that at home, but be very careful of your eyes. That's all I can say is be careful of your eyes. And read and research. And again, I'm not a medical professional, so I'd pay out of house for. Oh, you have the, when I said the cream that can dissolve the hair. I never thought they were that great. But and again, my skin is such that I'm taking my life in my hands when I do that. So, but I hope this gives you some ideas of options if you are struggling with this part of PCOS. Keto is great for PCOS. There's no doubt. You can listen. Dr. Kinberry has lots of videos on it, and he will talk about it. I think for me, and this is just a my experience, is that when I went on my keto carnivore journey, that all got better. It got less. And I didn't believe Dr. Barry when he said it would get less. I was like, yeah, right. Because once that happens, it's yours for life. And you know what? It did. It did get better. For me to do a video without makeup on would never have happened before. My hair has been thinning with age, which can also be a part of PCOS. And I feel like it's getting thicker. Of course, I'm eating lots of beef. Beef helps, all of that. So, because you're just getting all the good stuff. And I just, again, this is just my personal experience. So I hope this encourages you that there are things we ladies can do to make ourselves more comfortable with the extra quote blessings that we get sometimes with PCOS. And then as we age, menopause can cause this as well. If this hadn't started when I was young, I would have said, oh, this is all menopause. It's not. It's part of that. I mean, it all started with PCOS. So, do what helps you feel comfortable with yourself. And if you like what you're doing, don't change. I'm just giving you a quick review on these two items. And I hope that encourages you today. So I do want to end this with a quick chat about where I was yesterday. So yesterday, I was here by myself like I am today, and I was working on laundry taller than me. And it was on a table, a big tall folding table, but I still have hardly made a dent. I folded, massive mounds of laundry, and then I hung a lot of wet laundry and was trying to get all that done. Because I have all my new stuff that I'm running through right now, new or new to me. But I will tell you that as I pulled this big, well, the first thing I did was lift this big, huge hamper of clean clothes, take it down the hall into my room, and I absolutely damaged my knee. So then I spent 45 minutes using the infrared on my knee and all of that, and with some CBD oil and all of that. And then I was pulling the hamper into the bedroom, and it got caught in the doorway because in our bedrooms we have carpet in two of the three bedrooms, and it got caught, and I started to fall. I fell out of my shoe, slipped off. My husband's dresser, praise God, was there. It's what helped me catch myself. And as somebody who's broken two major breaks of bones in on that carpet, yeah, I was so thankful. And then the third time, which was it sealed the fate yesterday, I was trying all these recipes all day long. I was just cooking all day long, all these recipes, and adjusting because I wanted to save carbs and I wanted more protein and I didn't want to spend extra money. I was doing the whole, you know, cost effective kind of thing. And anyways, I was carrying on a Silpad hot pad, like you put down on the table, but you can carry things on it. Two little round ramekin, but they're Pyrex clear glass size bowls, and they were blistering hot. The recipe had failed. They were extra runny. And even though I had cooked them and cooked them for like an hour, and it was a 30-minute cook, so I literally, they began to wobble. I did not have anything on this hand. I know. And they were blistering hot. And one fell. And as I jerked to try to catch it, that was it, my back. And I almost fell. And I just can't express. And there I am with my back, like, killing me. And then I had to bend down and clean the mess up off the floor. And part of it went on the wood floor. Part of it went on the, you know, the yucky old linoleum. And, oh, my goodness. And I was literally physically, my stomach was ill. So, I mean, I was ill at that point. And I had to still make another whole round of that food, which I had already pre-done in the blender. So anyway, so I didn't, when it came time to film for you guys, I was green. I was absolutely green in severe pain. I broke down and took a prescription, arthritis pain, you know, kind of prescription ibuprofen type thing. And I didn't move for like an hour or two. I was in so much pain. And then my husband even cooked the dinner. I seasoned the meat. He cooked it out on the smoker for us. I just didn't move. I didn't move. So I apologize for yesterday not getting this up. I hope you guys enjoyed Erica Bell's her beautiful lip glosses. Such a lovely lady. So if you didn't get to watch that, go back and watch that video. And I hope that this video, these two videos today, kind of bridge the gap. They kind of help you guys see that there are tools that we can utilize with PCOS to make us feel better. And menopause, you could apply it to menopause too. So I just feel like as I go through this keto journey and I look at self-care, there are different things I'm looking at that I probably just patched and went on. And now, and I also was really bad about buying the cheapest thing I could find. And I learned my lesson today that I don't want cheaper things, that, you know, I don't want the chipper chicken. If you know that movie, leave a comment below. I'm behind on comments. I will get to those comments in the next couple of days. We now have an out-of-town thing that we had not planned on, and we are just so far behind trying to catch up. So we're trying. It's a lovely out-of-town thing, but anyways, it just wasn't in the plan. And the problem is my husband gets way behind, and then he just struggles to catch up. And so, and we've been behind, and now the trip that we thought we were going to fly out on for business in October looks like we're going to drive, which means it will be twice as long, 2 days of driving, going and coming. So it'll be a total of 4 days. And I love car trips with my husband. I really do. But we just have been gone so much, and we still want to go to New Mexico and all these other things. So I'm not sure how we're going to get all this in, but we'll see. We'll see. But anyway, so but I just wanted to explain kind of what's been going on. Besides all the I have a new camera that complete flop. Today was my last time to use it. It was much cheaper by the time I got it. I really tried to make it work. So I'm not sure what I'm going to do with it, but, I'm probably either going to return it or give it away or do something. And then my phone is still having endless fun things, but I'm trying to go back in through all the settings and reset everything, and coming short of resetting it to factory, I'm not sure what I'm going to do. I can't even get my watch. I have to reconnect and It's crazy. It's time for a new phone, but my husband's not super keen on that. So we're just gonna see. I'm just gonna see. I'd rather just have a nice new phone with a lot of storage on it because this one's pretty old. But I don't know. We'll see. You know how that is. You just have to be patient. It'll all come in time. That's kind of what's been the juggling the balls here, and I apologize. But I will tell you one last thing in the chat. For anybody that has the autoimmune like arthritis, or if you have bad knees, or if you're just unsteady on your feet, I bought a big, huge metal cart that folds up and folds down, and it has two big wheels in the back and a small two wheels in the front. They're like shopping carts. They don't look like a grocery cart. They just look like a rectangular upright cart. And my grandmother gave me one years ago when we first moved to San Antonio and our first child was born, because I had a long way to walk from the car to our apartment and I had a newborn. And she was like, you cannot. And I was, you cannot carry everything in your hands, the baby and the groceries and the this and the that. So she had these carts because she also had lots of arthritis and being steady on her feet type issues. So she would have me put my groceries in the cart, pull them to the stairs, take the baby up, and we just lived on the second floor. And we were one of two doors. So I could run upstairs, put her in her crib, and then come back, make sure she was safe and okay and happy, and then run back down and get my groceries. And I got an even bigger one with an even additional basket on the backside for like your purse, Oh my gosh. I used it yesterday. It doesn't do great on our, we have a crushed gravel walkway, but I think I'm figuring it out. And we have a couple of stepping stones. It doesn't like going up and over things, but I'm figuring out how to do it. That is a total game changer. I am so thrilled. I can go get my groceries. I can bring them in the house without going back and forth, up and down the ramp 10 times, which if you have bad knees, going up and down ramps are fantastic, but they are painful for me because our ramp is so steep. And so I didn't know if I could even roll that up the ramp. And you know what? My arms are getting stronger. And so I could do it. And even if I had to pull it up behind me, I would do it. And then I just rolled around the house and deposited all the groceries where they went. It was just so fantastic. I can put a picture of it on Instagram if you guys want to see it. It's nothing fancy. I just got it on, I think it was Amazon or Walmart.com. And I can't tell you. The first one I ordered from Amazon was in their warehouse deal and it came without a wheel. It was such a disappointment. And so this one totally bakes my cake. It looks nicer. It is nicer. And it has worked beautifully. So find the tools that work for you. Recognize what you can do and what you'd like to maybe do differently, like this or the cart or whatever, and live your best life because that's all you can do. And in this keto journey, this is one of the things that I'm learning. This ketogenic lifestyle is that I don't have to do what everybody else does. I just got to find what works for me. And that's my journey. So that's what I'm bringing to you. Again, I'm not medical. I'm not a doctor. I'm not a nurse. I'm sharing with you my journey, and I hope that that would encourage you today. All right, friends. I love you guys. I pray your day is blessed, creative, and lovely. Like, subscribe, leave a comment below. And if you have any suggestions for more effective hair removal, please feel free to leave it below. We'd all love to learn from each other, right? Please feel free to leave a comment. We are getting spammed comments. That's what's taking me so long. As well as if you ever get an email from Healthy Living for Him or Josephine's Designs, you come back to this channel, please get my email or message me on Instagram and say, "Did you send me something?" I will never ask you for any of your information. I will never ask you to click on something and come to it. Don't click on this link. I will never ask you to give me any information, your phone number. I will never ask you for your phone number in a million years. Never. I am just here to say that there are constant issues. We have gone through, and on top of that, three rounds of identity theft. in since we got home from Florida that I didn't even know. That I didn't even know. I've been addressing that in the last week, literally in the last week. So it has, and why our bank didn't catch it, I don't even get it. It was from my credit card for escort services. Yeah, there you go. I just was like, what did you say? So seriously, we marked it on you because it didn't seem like your normal. And I'm like, you let 4 or 5 months of this go through. And it was doing it under weird charges. And because my husband and I, there's one account we share, two we don't. But at first, I thought when it was on our account, and because they weren't noticeable, I didn't know what they were. Hold on, I've got another alarm going off. Sorry, guys. But long story short, it's there. The scamming is happening. It is on steroids right now. People are making a huge amount of money. And watch your accounts. Literally $1, $2, $3. That's where they'll start. And then they'll be charging every week. And then you're into hundreds and hundreds, if not thousands of dollars. Ours didn't get to the thousands, praise God. Our bank is so good. But I will tell you, it has been a nightmare. So if you get an email from Josephine's Designs or Healthy Living for Him, do not click on a link. The only way I would email you is if you had a drawing and you won something, or if you participated in a Bible journaling camp, and I was inviting you to the next Bible journaling camp, which would only happen during Bible journaling camp season, if that makes any sense. So, and again, there would be no link. There would be nothing to pay. There would be, don't send me your phone number. Don't. And unless I'm mailing out kits, you don't even need to give me your address. So, but if you get anything from me, you can private message me on Instagram and I will be glad to try to address that, and verify one way or the other. And, yeah. And my emails are on, listed below, so you'll be able to see them. So, and we are getting spammed and roboted or whatever they called botted on our comments as well, which seriously, why do people do that? I don't know. But I do have some things that might be coming up for us. So it'll be fun. Maybe some collaborations. I'm not sure. I just have to really kind of pray it through and think it through because I don't do a lot of that kind of stuff anymore. I was on a design team, on a couple of three design teams for a long time. And I just kind of am not sure I'm really into that anymore. So, but I will share things with you that I find that are hopefully a help. Okay, guys, long enough. I pray your day is blessed, creative, and lovely. I love you guys. I am going to try to get a Bible journaling film tonight. Not a Bible journaling, our Thanksgiving project, a gratitude project done tonight. But I also want to do last week and this week's Bible journaling because last week we were having problems too. So, and last week was all internet and phones. We were out for days. So, but we'll see what I have on time. I've got to get on that pile of clothes for a little while. And yeah. So, all right, guys. I love you guys as much as I love you. God loves you so much more. And welcome to all of our new friends, by the way. I've noticed we have a lot of new friends. Welcome, welcome, welcome. We love you. And thank you to all of our tried and true friends. All right, friends. I'll be talking to you soon. As much as I love you, God loves you so much more. Keep serving him well. And just trust he has a wonderful path for your life. All right, guys. Talk to you later. Bye now.